Hi friends, my name is Faiz. You are watching Start Crushing Sketch+Flinto. I'm sorry guys, I was on Manali trip. That's why I was unable to upload the videos on last weekend. I'm really sorry for that. So I'll show you, we have done lots of fun over there and next video. And in this video, we are going to learn how to make product page in Sketch. Also going to add the transition effect into Flinto. Before starting this video, just press the subscribe button and bell notification icon so you don't miss anything. So please subscribe me. So today we are going to make this product page and also the expand view of my product. So now when user will be click on this product, it will be expand like this. So this transition effect we will give into Flinto. So I hope you will enjoy this tutorial and you will learn about the symbol, how to use symbol and the auto layout I will use in this tutorial. So now we are going to make this. Just simply create the new file into your Sketch. And this product page I have designed into iPhone 7 Plus artboard. So it is really easy to make this. Just press the A in your keyboard, click on this 7 Plus artboard. So this is your artboard. It is very simple. So what I'm going to do in this tutorial, I'll teach you. So the first one, I'm going to create the header, the primary header and the secondary header and the cards. So this is my basic structure to make this product page and it is so easy. So first of all, going to create the header. Like 60 pixel, okay, and remove the border. First of all, we will add the icons. So I'm using the icon font plugin for Sketch. I'll mention the link in my description. You can download the plugin and install that. So there's a lots of icon that you can use, like menu and the other thing, and the other icon will be search. This video will be a longer, so hope so you will enjoy this video. It is really nice to teach you something different, like search icon. Okay, so both icon is a fonts. Right now I am going to convert this into line. So convert to line, you will see this. Now this is converted into line. Also select all and give the size 24. Okay, great. So this one is 20 pixel margin from the left and the right. Okay, and the middle line, oops, middle align. Okay, fine. Now going to add the heading over here, like collection, formatting this like 15 pixel, Roberto, medium, uppercase. It is very simple formatting. Okay, great. So this is I have done. And now select all thing, middle align. So it is fine. I have made this navigation bar in few seconds. So second thing, I'm going to add the shadow. So I have a ready-made shadows which I have downloaded from some website. I also mentioned this link in description. You can also download this. So going to copy this style in my file, just right click, paste style over here, so you can easily adopt that style. Also remove the first shadow, looking nice. And now going to add the secondary header. It will be like 40 pixel and this one. So in this header, I'm going to add something. I'm going to use some other things like auto layout, which is make my workflow really fast. So I'll teach you that how to use. Let's suppose I have a link. This one is like all. Okay. And like this one is a 13. The medium. Okay, so first thing, I'm going to create this into stack. So just click on this and it will be automatically convert into a stack. The second thing what I'm going to do, the second thing I'm going to copy this stack and again paste over here. So let's suppose I'm changing name over here, new collection. So again I'm going to create the stack of both element. So just click on this three dotted and now there's a new stack group. So what it will do, just copy stack, double click on the link and copy stack and paste over here, paste again. So now you can see the magical thing is happening over here. It is automatically adjust the size, layer and everything. So let's suppose when I change the name of this layer like shirts, see the magic, trouser. So let's suppose if I need some spacing between the two links, it is very easy. Just click on three dots like 20 pixel over here. See, it is quite nice. I'm going to add it 30 pixel between the elements. Okay, that's it. So just change this color and the font weight like regular, okay, and also going to color like this will fine. Okay, this is my activated, so it is quite nice. Also change the color. First of all, group this header, the primary header group, and forward on top, going to add some opacity over here, not changing color. So you will be able to see the shadow effect on top. Otherwise, the shadow automatically hide because of fill color. Okay, so now you understand that how to make the navigation by using the stack autofillow, auto layout. Okay, so now just changing the background color over here. Like I'm using the F1, F2, F5 color code. Great. So going to create the card. This card over here. This one. So just copy this card over here. And this is my card which I'm going to create. So you can create easily, I know it. So just simply this. So now understand. In this card, I have a two section, the first section of the image and the second option of the content. You have to create the another rectangle over here like this, like 190 pixel and also 180. Remove the border. Okay, fine. Add the image over here. So it is very simple. Just go to in my folder, where is the images, and just add this image. Okay, and now resize this and marks with this. So it is very simple. Okay, I hope you understand how to do it. And the second one is a formatting, is a font size and the other thing. So in my file you can see there is a text, it is a 13 and the proper font regular, and this one is a bold 15 and this one is a discount. So just I'm going to copy this, not creating. So this is my details of my card. So now I'm going to create the symbol of this card, this complete card, so it will be easily manage everything. Just create symbol over here. So I'll tell you what I mean by that, what is benefit of that. So now you can see over here there is a field I can change, the text will be changed, the price will be changed, and the title will be changed. It is very easy. Also, the image will be changed. This is really nice. This is very super easy way to work. Let me give you the example. Let's suppose I have another rectangle, another symbol over here. Just duplicate this symbol and I want to change the photo. So what I can do, just simply drag the photo over here. You can see the plus icon and drop there. The photo will be changed. It is very simple. It is very, very simple. I hope you understand what I mean. So for now, just going to copy my all cards from my design file. So it is simple. I hope you understand how to make this. You can see every card has different image and it is very simple. You can see it is very easy. Okay, fine. So now move on to the next screen. Just going to create the another artboard over here. Just iPhone 7 Plus. And also adding this image over here. Just copy and paste over here. So this is like this. Now create the rectangle over here, overlap for the information like this. Also edit the rectangle, just double click over here, take this point and drag. So I hope you understand that how I create this section. So for now I am not going to create this, just copy this whole information and going to paste over here. So this is nice. You can see over here there are my detail, like heading 13, 15, 16 will be title and the description 13 and the colors. So it is quite nice. Also this is my float button to add this item into the list, and there is also back button on the top which I am going to add over here. Nice. So I hope you understand that how I made all screens. Change the color of this. I just forgot to change color. Okay, this is looking cool and nice. It's beautiful. And now we are going to work on animation. For this, we are going to send this into Flinto, this artboard. So just click on the send Flinto. It is a plugin. Now I'm into Flinto. So now what I have to do, when I'll click on my whole card, this is my whole card, the image will be come. So I'm going to make this clickable. So there's a gesture, is a click tap as a tap and targeting the artboard and going to create new transition. I'm going to create the new animation according to me. So first thing, I'm going to overlap this screen into this. There is a shortcut, click on a line. Let me make some quick things like this one. Just going to down, the opacity will be 0 and also this arrow will be left, the opacity will be 0. So you can see this animation. So when I'll click on the product page, it will become like this. Okay. And the second step is going to connect this product with this product. So what I mean by that, I'll show you. When I'll click on this, it will be zoom in and will become like this. And when I'll click on back button, it will be look like this. Okay, so for this there is a one option in Flinto, you can connect both layer each other. So for example, I have my layer, I have this layer, this product, and I'm going to connect this layer. So when I click on play button, see, this is beautiful. Also I can give you the example on the preview mode. When I click on this button, it is looking quite nice. Yep. So just going to add some bouncing effect.
So like, let's suppose little bouncing effect, not more. Let me check. Yes, that's nice. And also this one, this one, the group, this is my group. I'm going to add some animation, the bouncing effect over here. That's nice, and give some delay timing. Now let me check the preview. So when I'll click on the this card, it will become like this. Nice. So it is looking nice. Now second thing what I'm going to do, I'm going to clickable this button, then you can go back. It is very simple, just click on the tab key and add the target backlink, so it will be forward on that screen. It is very simple. Let me give you the example. When I am over here and just click in this, it is simple. So I hope you understand that how to make this. And the bonus thing, I am going to give you the some tips over here. Like for example, this is my the secondary to make scrollable. So it is simple, just click on a group over here and you can see it is a scrollable. So it is really nice. Also, if you want to make the product scroll, if you want to make scroll your product, so the same thing will be used over here. Just select your all products and click on scroll group. So now you can scroll this very easily. So let's see. And also this one. And also this one. It is nice. I hope you enjoy my tutorial. You understand that how to work with Sketch and Flinto, and you can make more beautiful interaction and design. And please, if you like my video, please give me a thousands of like and subscribe my channel. I'll come with a lots of new material. I'll teach you that how to work on perfect design. So please subscribe my channel if you're watching this video. Also, I'm going to add this file into description. You can download this and do the practice, and I hope you will enjoy this. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thanks a lot.